everybody. This is James with Fair Park Comics. Tonight I've got some Whatnot auction buys. I've got three different people I got comics from. Maybe four. I'll have to look. There's a lot here. This first one, the live stream was Random Stacks. Mystery pulls with a chance at getting a slab, a good one. They had some decent slabs up there. They had one in particular I really liked. There's three slabs that could be won. You had to buy three comic packs, and then you got a chance at a slab. Everything had numbers on them already. You just picked a number off a board. Whatever that number was, you picked it, and you either got a slab or you didn't. You got another book. So the first one, they had a maximum deal and everything. The first three I got, I believe, it was these three. It was either these three or these three. I think Darkhawk was, or both in it. But the first one, I didn't get the slab, but I think it was the Alpha Captain America Cold War. But no, it was the Deadpool. The Deadpool was the prize. So I got a Darkhawk 3, Darkhawk 4, and then Captain America Alpha. And I believe Deadpool was the prize. But that's a pretty cool one. The next lot was, I believe it was these three. Venom 200, or Venom 35, Legacy 200. I love that. I love it. Moon Knight number one. This is a third print of this one. I don't know if it's the newest series. I'll have to look. And then a X-Men 2099 number 3 from 1993. Whew! And I believe the Star Wars Adventures was the pick instead of me getting a slab. The number I... Yeah, because there's the number on the back. No, that can't be it. This is not... Oh, okay, I see. These two were the picks. So, the last one I had, the last bag had also had a Mary Jane, Amazing Mary Jane in it, number one. Sorry, I got that all mixed up. But these were the two, instead of getting a slab, I got these guys. Star Wars Adventures, Tales of Villainy. I think there's some first appearances in this. And then the X-Men 2099 number 3. Decent thing of books. I like what I got there. I was satisfied with the win on that. It didn't cost me very much. I think the value of the books that I got there definitely... I'll definitely be able to turn those. Some of those I will keep. The next one here, I'm going to go ahead and take this out of the box here, is from Stash Loot. All these events were very well packaged. All of them using either Gemini or Gorilla Collectible Supplies. I didn't know they were still in business. But everything was packaged really well. Sorry. Basically, Lex the Looter was on, and I ran across his show. And I found 14 books. And, I mean, I think I got nearly all of them for a dollar each. But... this is what I got. And he's got a deal I guess he's got some temps. Your friendly neighborhood warehouse team. So they've got a little deal that they do with the people that they've got doing this. Now, I like these books. These books are amazing. Harbinger 1. It's a Valiant comic. I still got it. I think that's a cool looking cover. I love this Spider-Gwen Smash number 1. I've got a foil, but not of this picture, but I love that picture. Then we got the Champions number 1. It's a variant there. I still don't know what this is. I need to find out. Maybe it tells. No, he just does not tell. Let me see what this is. I'm not quite sure. I take the tape off. Yeah, let's see what this might be. It's a cool cover. Virgin cover. Once Upon a Time at the End of the World, Book 1. That is cool. Looks like it's got an old Sherman tank that she's sitting on. Let me double check that and make sure. Yeah, that's what it is. This is number 3. Maybe that's number 3. I'll find out. But that is a beautiful picture. I love the cover of that. I want to read that one. I want to get a different copy to read. I don't want to mess this one up. But yeah, that's Once Upon a Time at the End of the World. That's a cool one. Then I got this Wolverine. I guess it's the facsimile. This is the variant cover. So that's cool. I like that. It was a dollar. So this one I really love. It's a second print of Amazing Spider-Man number 26. That's just a cool looking picture. That is a beautiful cover. So I got that. Again, here's another Harbinger 1. I love that cover. That's cool. Here's another one I got. I'm wondering what it is. Let me get into this one real quick. I'm not quite sure. I remember them saying when we got it. I just saw the tattoo and I thought that was a really cool book. Damn Them All. It's a Whatnot issue number 1. I guess a Whatnot exclusive from Boom Comics. Damn Them All. That's cool. So, got it for a dollar. I think it's a $10 book. But we'll see. This one is called Rush. It's Rush number 1. It's a cover B by Simmons. I'm not exactly sure who that one is, but from Vault Comics. That's just a cool looking picture. Nice cover. All these books that I got from these guys have been crisp. There's nothing wrong with them. They actually could probably be sent in for grades and would probably grade a 9.8, maybe a 9.9 on some of them. Killadelphia number 17. I don't remember getting that one, but I did. I guess it's the eyes. I had to get this. I don't have one, so I broke down and said, okay, I'll bid a dollar on it. What the heck? So I grabbed that guy for a dollar. It reminds me of Adam Bomb. So, Woody the Whatnot Buddy. So I thought that was kind of cool. Here's another question mark. It's a Virgin cover. I was busy doing something. And I heard Virgin cover, so I bid on it. So that's how I got these. Another Once Upon a Time. This is number four. Once Upon a Time at the End of the World. Well, it says number four. It says number four. But that's got octopus tentacles coming up out of the water. And last, no, there's two more. We got this one. Oh, that's the one I didn't want to show you yet. I got this Detective Comics number 1063. I'm not sure the significance on this one, but I picked that one up. I like my Detective Comics Batmans. I don't know what my fascination with it is it all of a sudden, but that, and this is my first Virgin, oh no, I'm sorry, it's my second Virgin Vampirella cover. I have one that's signed by Lauren Wright that I got signed at back in December at one of the local shows in Louisville, Texas. But that was that one from Random Stacks. You can find them on Whatnot. I'm sure he's on right now, probably. If not tonight, he will be tomorrow night. And if you like what you see here, like, comment, subscribe, and let me know what you think. You will also be able to find me on Whatnot on Fridays at 8:30. I'm trying to decide what my other days are going to be, but I'm going to try to do 2 days a week. Also, eBay, Facebook, gosh, there's everything out there. Instagram, on all of it. So, see what I've got out there. This one is coming from The Mellow, from I want to say Massachusetts. I may be getting that wrong. I'm sorry, dude, if I did. If you see this. But here's these books. These books. Now, is it? Just like everybody else. Gotta use Gemini. Gemini mailers. Everything's coming. No damage to the books. Nothing. Everything looks great. I love how they're putting those in. I need to get some of those for mine. I like that. Well, I guess you saw the first one. And again, this is a cover C. It's a Peach Momoko Dynamite Vampirella cover. I couldn't resist that. Then I got a Thundercats number one. I believe this is a 1 in 25 or 1 in 10. I think it's 1 in 25. I'll have to find out for sure. Thundercats number one. Here's a version of Thundercats number one. I don't know which one this is. I'll have to find that out as well. I remember him telling during the video, but I didn't. It's been a week. And then Cobra Commander. If I remember correctly, this is a 1 in 25 or 1 in 50. I want to say it's the 1 in 50, but I'm not sure. But my first one of these, this is the background. It was like they had back in the 80s, the background on the toys, the soldiers and the toys that they had on the shelf. That's the background that was behind the soldiers. Whenever you bought your little army men. So there's that one. That was from The Mellow. And last but not least, this one is from SMZ Enterprises. These guys, I mean, these are wow. Gemini case as well came looking beautiful. SMZ Comics. I spent a few bucks on these, it looks like. Yes, I did. Yeah, I hiccuped on this one. But I got some really nice stuff here. I got three virgin. Well, I think this one's a virgin copy. I think this is a something's killing the children. I believe. Yeah, something just made me go ahead and get it. God, these books are in such amazing shape. I just want to make sure that's what this is. Yes, Something's Killing the Children, number 20. So, Something's Killing the Children, number 20. Let's set that up there. And this is a. I don't remember if this is a Edge of the Spider-Verse. Oh my goodness. I got some good stuff here. But this is a virgin cover. I'm gonna have to find out which one it is. As far as the. Is that two? Oh crap, it's got two in there. Alright. Alright, good. I got an extra one. For oh wow. Nerd Pharmaceuticals. Spider-Man number one. Wow. That's freaking cool. I love the Spider-Mans. I'm trying to complete that series, but that is an awesome one. I love that. So we'll set that guy up there. And this is another Spider-Man. I'm surprised he didn't write this on the back. See if I can get this off of here real quick. I'm taking the tape off, then I'm putting one back on. I just less room for error. That one. Let's see which one this one. And this one's, I like that. They double boarded them. This is another number one. Oh. Amazing Spider-Man number one. It's a whatnot variant. Okay. That's interesting. So it's a whatnot exclusive. Amazing Spider-Man. Oops, I took it out. Oh, messed up. Let's get that back in there real quick without messing the book up. So whatnot exclusive. That's a pretty cool one. You gotta like that. So let's go ahead and stick this back on here. And we'll set him up there as well. And last but not least, Amazing Spider-Man number 19, Legacy of 913, again variant. That wow, that's just a cool looking picture. Nice cover. All these books are in amazing shape. Yeah, the corners like point. All the corners are point. This one's gradable. I may send that in and get it graded if it's a decent book. But yeah, that's a beautiful cover. But guys, if you liked what you saw here, by all means, like, subscribe, comment. Let me know what you think. Hopefully, I'll have some more for you in the next few days. I'm saying a lot again. But yeah, that was my whatnots from last week. Hopefully, I'll have you some more tomorrow night. But check me out on whatnot. Check out my eBay store, Fair Park Comics. Y'all have a wonderful night.